So today we're taking a closer look at the black walnut. So we're into the fall season, and today we're going to talk about walnuts. And we're going to put together some walnut tincture. Walnuts are known to be heart healthy, excellent trailside snack, and the tincture is great for treating parasites. Not as much study, but some study shows benefits for gut health, heart health, reducing blood pressure. So there are definitely some benefits. It's certainly, the tincture can be used as an antiseptic and for wound treatment. You can actually use just the hull of the black walnut and the iodine that it produces to treat topical conditions such as fungus and so forth, and as well as preventing infections. So we're going to talk about black walnuts in this video, and I hope you'll go along for the ride and let us know if you have some feedback, experience, or ideas. I'm a little bit late harvesting some black walnuts for some tincture and iodine-rich tincture. You might want to put on some gloves when harvesting these, because they'll certainly stain your fingers. What I'm looking for is any walnuts that still have a bit of the yellow to green coloration in their hull. There's some debate as to how far the hull can go and you still have all of the nutrient benefits. However, what I'm really after is the iodine benefits found in the walnut for topical uses. So we're going to grab a few of these in varying coloration. Doesn't take a lot, and we're going to make a tincture. So one of your biggest challenges once you've gathered a few of these black walnuts is going to be removing that hull. And as it's turning green to black this late in the fall, starts to dry out pretty nicely. So it's a great time to gather those, rip that hull off. By hand is just fine. What I find works really well is a pressure washer. You take a pressure washer to that, and as you can see, they clean up really nicely. So these have been laying out and drying for some time. We'll give them a crack and see what we find inside. One of my favorite ways to crack these is a tool just like this. And typically what I'll do is just get that nut in there, and then the nut that I'm cracking, I'm gonna cover it with a towel. So as I crack it and those pieces spread or shatter, they're all contained, so I also don't lose any of the meat of the nut. One of my favorite tools when I'm cracking black walnuts is my awl. This is actually just a sewing awl that I keep in my emergency sewing kit. It goes with me all the time, and so it's multi-purpose. If I need to pick at a nut and get that flesh from the nut, I can do that with this little awl. So I can get that in those difficult to reach areas and start picking the meat out. And unfortunately, this nut doesn't have a lot, but got a little bit there. But the key is having that awl handy so you can pick out the nuts. But eating the flesh of the walnut isn't the only way to get the health benefits. Another great way to use these walnuts is to make tincture with the hull, which is rich in iodine and antimicrobial, antibacterial, anti-parasitic, and can be used to as an antiseptic for wound treatment. It helps to clear up fungus, so a number of skin conditions. It's there's so many different remedies for which it's rumored. I hate to mention a lot of them, but just Google the health benefits of black walnut. You'll find many resources, and so here's the tincture. So obviously the first thing we want to do is give our walnuts just a little bit of a rinse. And it doesn't take a lot, but clearly they've been on the ground, so we want to remove any obviously loose dirt, their stems, and set those clean walnuts aside. And again, it doesn't take a lot of these. I'm going to be making two small jars of tincture. This is not a piece of my apothecary that I turn to frequently. But again, an excellent source of iodine and other natural uses. So we'll talk about that in a moment. To prepare your black walnut tincture,
I always don something old that's stained and I'm not too worried about. And put down some butcher paper so we're not staining the countertop, because the tannins in this will stain anything and everything that it gets to. So I like my shells soft, still a bit green. And literally all I'm going to do is break those hulls apart. And yes, I do break mine up. And I want some of that black, I want some of that green. And I'm going to stuff that into my jars. I've seen a number of videos where they actually do not go to this trouble. I understand, it's messy, causes some staining. But I also feel that we're getting the most from the hull this way. And I do want the different stages of the hull's progress and decomp for the added benefits. And so I am going to score the hull in a number of places so that we get as much of the internal qualities from the hull that we can harvest. So we're going to the trouble of making the tincture. We want to make sure the tincture is going to provide us with the benefits that we're looking for. So I tear that, expose as much of the fibers as I can, and simply, as with all my, I love that smell, add the vodka. And we want just enough of the vodka so when we press that in, it's going to cover my hulls. This tincture will last, will remain shelf stable for years. Again, it's not a tincture that I use very frequently. So I'm past the messy part. I get rid of the gloves. Put my lids on that jar. So all I've done is just press that down into my tincture or my vodka. Put my lids on nice and secure. Yep, I'm going to give that a little bit of a wipe. And those are going to sit in a dark closet for 4 to 6 weeks. And then I will filter it and move it to a dropper bottle. And that's ready for use. And we'll talk a little more about how we use this and why I actually add this to my apothecary.
So while my tincture is finished, all I need to do is run that through some cheesecloth or a screen to filter it, and then it's ready for use, and I'll put it into a dropper bottle and keep it in my travel apothecary. This tincture goes in my EDC apothecary because it's an excellent treatment.